Hello, we hope everybody's doing all right. Today we have another solar panel for you we're going to take a look at. It's a miniature one made by Flex Solar. This is a 6-watt solar panel, 5 volts. So it has one USB-A output. It has PET film packing technology and is IP68 waterproof. It says that it can charge mobile phones and a whole bunch of other devices, small lights. It's about 10.6 inches long, 6.8 inches wide, and about 0.1 inches thick. So it's a pretty thin panel if you take a look at it. It has a stretchable USB-A cord on the back of it. And it retails for $15.99 on Amazon, but there is a $2 coupon that brings it down to $13.99, so 14 bucks. This will probably make a good emergency panel to charge stuff. At 6 watts, don't expect much, maybe 1 amp or so. So we're just scrolling through some of the specs and what they claim. They have 4 ring holes in each corner. So 1 in each corner, total of 4 to mount it. It came with some carabiners, but we're not gonna show them. They weren't really nothing special and they didn't fit in the eyelet. So I guess you have to tie some type of zip ties or something on it. And what you would do is just basically plug your USB device into it. And it says that it's got 6 watts, 5 volts at 0.9 amps. So you get about 1 amp out of this thing. Do not expect lightning fast charging if it even reaches 1 amp. High efficiency conversion rate, 24%. It's a monocrystalline panel. They're showing like a small nightlight, a small fan, and then somebody riding a bike. So it must have full sunlight. Doesn't look like it has any reversing diodes or anything, so that means that this is probably not good in ultra low light conditions. It says that 5 to 8 years outdoor normal use, less than 0.5 pound. All right, and that's really about it. So we'll take a look at it. As we can see there, everything looks pretty nice. I mean, all the solder joints are nice, they're clean. Everything looks okay. On the back side here, we have the Flex Solar QR code, probably for to go to the website for the manual. Some lettering, a little tiny cover here, and then we have a stretchy cord for the USB-A. No indicator light or anything that shows that it's on. It is pretty thin. It feels like around in between here, there's 2 layers of plastic. Let's see if we can get this in focus. Might be really hard. There it is. Yeah, it's hard to show. But there's 2 layers of plastic over the solar panel, and then there's a solar panel in the middle, that lighter color. So there's a layer of plastic, the solar panel, and another layer of plastic, that PET material. But it also has some type of silicone or rubber sealant around here, so it does feel waterproof. Then it has the ringlets here, the eyelets. So you could probably seal this with a little more silicone to make it perfectly waterproof, but should be fine in rain. It's pretty rigid, doesn't really bend, so you can put it in your backpack. It's not really gonna scratch that much, and stretching the cord is pretty decent, a couple feet at least. So yeah, let's go outside, plug this thing into a phone, and see what we can get. All right, we got the Flex solar panel set up here in full sunlight. We are bringing in around, sorry for the glare there, let's try and fix this. 5.16 volts, we're gonna plug it into a dead phone and see what we got. All right, definitely powered up the phone here. And we are bringing in around 1 amp. That's pretty good. So we'll let this thing charge up and see what happens. All right, everything here is set up on Bluetooth. You see we're bringing in just under 5 volts. 1.9 amps at around 5.4 watts. So they say this is a 6-watt panel. It is right there. So it is charging. Everything is good. QC 2.0 is the charge. And we'll just let it keep going. All right, it's been going for about 23 minutes now. Still bringing in just under 5 volts. We've seen as high as 1.12 amps, which was about 5.5 watts. So it's right within that 6-watt specification. We've charged 416 milliamp hours. The little dip in the graph up there you see was when we were moving the panel just to follow the sun. And as you see there, it's QC 2.0. Everything's charging just fine. We checked the phone out there. We had shut it off at about 1%, and it's about 10% now. So it's definitely charging the phone. So we'll leave it out there for about an hour. All right, we charged it for about an hour. The sun's passing through some clouds now and through some trees. So you see there, it's got less than a watt coming in now. But we did 986 milliamp hours. It's been about an hour. So that's right about where it should be. An amp for an hour would give you 1,000 milliamp hours. We're gonna go check the phone and see what the percentage is and how much we charged in roughly an hour. And we started charging it at 1% with the phone off. All right, it was still showing that it's charging here, 17%. So we gained about 16% of the battery in an hour. That is not bad for an emergency situation. Not bad at all. So we'll bring it back in and check it out and talk about it. All right, so we've seen out there with the phone hooked up, roughly about an hour, we were getting an amp, and we did have it angled in the sunlight. So we moved it around until we got the best reading out of the meter. But in about an hour, we charged 16, 17% of the battery on this is a newer phone, Android 12. So it's got one of the biggest batteries on the market, and it charged, like we said, about 16, 17, 18%, somewhere around there. That's pretty good. So for a sub $15 panel with the USB-A output, again, don't expect lightning results. It will charge devices. And in an emergency, this may be life-saving. So definitely, we think it's worth the buy. The panel didn't get hot at all. It actually fell down one time and didn't get any damage. The charging cord to the phone actually broke, but no damage to the panel. It seems very durable. Seems like it'll last a long time. And it said it output 6 watts. We got about 5.4, 5.5, somewhere around there at 1 to 1.1 amps. So it's right on with what the manufacturer puts out, the specs that they state. So definitely a good buy, definitely good product. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.